Hello everyone and welcome back to Learning Power BI and Accessible Design. If you're new here, my name is Julianne Smith and I'm here to make Power BI easier and more accessible. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create a custom column in Power Query that allows us to group smaller data slices into another category for a cleaner and more meaningful pie chart. This approach aligns with the idea I discussed in my blog post, Pie Charts versus Donut Charts, the sweet and the sour of data visualization. In that post, I emphasized that if your chart contains several small categories, it's worth considering grouping them into another category to enhance clarity and readability. When working with data visualizations, pie charts can get cluttered if there are too many small slices. By grouping these smaller categories together, we can simplify the chart while preserving valuable insights. Let's have a look how to do it. So first I'm going to show you the data. So my data has a column with the department where the department can occur more than once and a second column that has got the costs. So let's head to Power Query now. And my first step is grouping the data by department. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to first duplicate my original query. I'm going to rename it. And now I'm going to be able to group. So I'm going to select department. And then on my home tab, I'm going to group by. Then I'm going to group the department. My new column name will be total. The operation is going to be a sum of the column costs. There we go. So this step aggregates the data so that all the costs associated with each department are summed up into a single value. Grouping ensures that we are working with a clean and consolidated. Once we have the department level totals, we need to calculate the overall total cost across all departments. This will allow us to calculate the percentage contribution of each department. And to do that, we're going to add a custom column. And my new column is going to be called overall. And for that, I am going to use the function list.sum, which takes a list of numbers as input and calculates the total sum of those numbers. And then I'm going to open a bracket. I am now going to add my previous step, which is grouped rows. So I'm going to add. Rows, and then I am going to add my total. And then I'm closing my bracket. And here I have my overall total. Now I'm just going to format as a number. So the next step, I need to create another custom column to calculate the percentage, and that is a bit simpler. So I'm just going to add another custom column. I'm going to call it percentage. And the calculation is the total, so the total that we have per department. And I'm going to divide that by the overall total. So there we go. This divides the total cost for each department by the overall total cost, giving us a percentage value for each row. Now comes the final step. I need now to categorize these smaller slices. So in this case, I want to label all the departments that contribute with less than 5% of the total as other. And these will keep the chart clean and emphasizing the more significant categories. My cutoff point is 5%, but this can depend on your data set. So you don't need to strictly use 5%. To do that, we're going to add another column, but that this time we're going to add a conditional column. And for my conditional column, I'm going to call it new department. And my conditional is if the percentage is less than 0.05, which is 5%, then I want it to be named other. Else, if the percentage is above 5%, then I can use the original department. So I'm going to select my column department. So there we go. Now we have our new department. I'm going to just format as text. And the other two columns that we created, overall total and percentage, we can actually remove them. So at the end of these steps, we now have this new category that groups all the smaller departments into other category. And this column can be used as the legend in our pie chart. Let's have a look now. So I'm going to close and apply. I'm going to add a pie chart. Yeah. The total of, I'm going to add the total on my values, and I'm going to use my new department on the legend. And then we can just format to make sure that it's easier to read the text. The font's a bit small, so I can just go to my detail labels. What I'm going to do, I'm going to add my series label as well. I'm going to increase the font size. It's a bit too big. Make it 14. There we go. And I don't want the legend now because I have the series name. So I'm going to disable my legend. And now I want my percentage to just have, not to have any decimal. So again, I can just go under my values and percentage decimal places 0. And then we can now just improve the title. And here we have our final pie chart. By taking this approach, we not only simplified our chart, but also ensure the data remains accurate and easy to interpret. This technique can be applied to any data set where you want to aggregate smaller slices into another group. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more Power BI content. For now, it's goodbye and see you in the next video.